guys, this is Comic Uno. Today I'm doing a review for one of my favorite weekly series, a series I look forward to every week, because it's a weekly series, and that's Batman Eternal. Humongous Batman family fan, and Bat family fan, so been really enjoying Batman Eternal. So before I start talking about this issue though, just want to give you guys a little update. Of course, I have Comic Uno episode 47, and that's to show or review all the comics I read this week in one show. So let's get started with those exclusive comics. We have Real Heroes issue 2, Grim Fairy Tales issue 97, Madame Frankenstein issue 1, Angel and Faith season 10 issue 2, The Woods issue 1, Powerpuff Girls issue 9, Iron Fist The Living Weapon issue 2, Detective Comics issue 31, and The Wake issue 8. So if you want to go check out all those reviews, go to Comic Uno episode episode 47, so be sure to check that out. That'll be annotated. And guys, we also did Media Madness this week for Vampire Diaries season 2 episode 1 and 2, so if you want to go check that out, go check out that link, which will be titled Media Madness Vampire Diaries. So that's our commentary on Vampire Diaries. But let's start talking about Batman Eternal issue 5. Already up to issue 5. Don't you guys remember when issue 1 came out 5 weeks ago? But yeah, cool cover. Obviously we see that Tim Drake's in this one. We haven't seen Tim Drake in a while with the Bat Family. Really like the cover. Thought the orange worked for this. Even though I feel like the Batman Eternal covers are so plain. They never really explain what's going on with the story. And you really never get a gist of what the story is going to be about with the covers. And that kind of disappoints me with Batman Eternal. Especially, like, looking at future covers. I'm like, well, I still don't really know what character's going to be in that issue. And still, like, when you open up, you really don't know which Bat Family character is going to be in it. So I think that's kind of the cool mystery part of Batman Eternal. But cool art. Let's see what's going on with the story, though. So in this issue, we get to see more of Professor Pig's story, which he was taking over these children, and we learn that they had this virus even before Professor Pig encountered them, but he probably just ignited the disease, this techno disease, and this is why the children are sick. And we find out that Harper Rowe's brother, Colin, has the same sickness, and that's why Red Robin's going to try to find Colin. So, separate story, we get to see Harper Rose going into action, just wanting to help people, and finds Vicky Val, who is our other story. Vicky Val is still our detective slash journalist who wants to find out the real story about Gordon and this whole gang war. So she's like, well, I'm going to be a real journalist and go to a horrible part of town, even though this is not a good idea. She almost gets killed, but Harper Rose saves her. So they all end up in the same house where Colin's going crazy with his flu thing. And that's the whole issue. We just get to see all those stories interweave and really come together. And that's it. I want to see if there's other cliffhangers. Nope, that's pretty much it that happens in this issue. I like this issue because we get to see characters we really haven't seen in a while. Harper Rowe is one character that I really was impressed with Batman Eternal. Well, Batman issue 28 issue, which was the prelude to Batman Eternal. I was really impressed with her character. And we see that she's starting to become a vigilante. And how does she become Bluebird? How does she become that character? Which I'm sure we're going to see like halfway through Batman Eternal. But she's starting. And I really like that. Also, Colin's getting into the action with his techno disease. And I really loved how they weaved the stories together. And everyone kind of ended up in the same place by the end. Vicky Val, haven't seen her in a while either, so utilizing her character, I've always liked her character, I would say ever since Red Robin, she was a big vital part in that series, so seeing Red Robin and Vicky Val together, I thought was kind of a nice, I don't think they did it on purpose, but I thought it was a nice little nod to the Red Robin series, Prenuf 2. Written by Yost for a while, or Yost, however you pronounce his last name, no one ever knows what's his real last name. But yeah, so I really enjoyed all that. I like that Tim Drake was very in character here, because I really haven't been enjoying Tim Drake, New 52-wise. And I thought he was very much in character with his interactions with Batman, even though his costume still sucks. But I liked, he's still not my Tim Drake, because a lot of things he says is like, well, I teamed up with you as Red Robin, like, he was never Robin, which kind of upsets me. So a lot of his past has been erased. Hopefully recreated as Stephanie Brown comes back. Maybe we'll see more recreation of Tim Drake. But yeah, so but at least he seems a little bit more familiar with his attitude in this issue. But yeah, this is a solid issue. I don't think this was one of the best Batman Eternal issues, but it was solid. Again, I like seeing different characters we haven't seen in a while. But I thought a big problem with this issue was the art. Again, it's a different artist from last time, which had a different style bad art. But this, the proportions weren't kind of great. That's Red Robin's lip. That's an example. Yeah, so the proportions are definitely off throughout the issue. The coloring's great, but the faces aren't really that great, which is disappointing because you could see that there's a lot of potential in the art, and it's actually very similar to the first three issues, that artist, but again, the portions of their faces kind of are distracting throughout this whole issue, especially that first page. I don't know what was going on with Red Robin's lips there. But yeah, I'm gonna give this 4 stars. I thought it was a very solid issue. Like the story still, and I'm still very impressed with Batman Eternal, even though it hasn't been as perfect since the beginning. I'm sure there's gonna be up and down issues, but I've been pretty impressed with the series overall, and I'm still very excited to read the rest. So I'll give this 4 stars. I thought it was a solid issue. Hope you guys enjoyed. This is Comic Unknown, guys. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter for Comic Unknown and the Rent Situations, and don't forget to like my Facebook page. And I'll see you guys later.